helping us identify corporate communism in our country that is a cancer on our nation. The folks at the Sunlight Foundation, Jake Brewer, a little sunlight's a very powerful thing for those who like to use money to steal from us. Sheila Krumholtz, Executive Director for the Center for Responsive Politics, and its website, opensecrets.org, which is where we're able to find out who is getting bought off by who. And then you can see here, of course, Jonathan and Karen. Jake, I will begin with you. Walk us through how it is that the lobbyists are controlling this process.
Well, the thing with the lobbyists is that they're not able, we're not able to track the real influence that they're having, or at least we weren't until last week. And what we were able to find is that they're actually coming together to form these clusters of influence. And so, along with Sheila and her team at the Center for Responsive Politics, we're able to find that lobbyists are coming together in large numbers and giving large sums of money that is actually having much, much more influence than we were originally able to track. And again, we're running up into a case where we have a 19th century government process, or practically so, coming up to a 21st century citizenry that demands this type of accountability and transparency. And we're now able to track that through new investigation that we've been able to uncover.
So, Sheila, how does this work? In other words, if I understand correctly, lobbyists are actually giving their own money, and then if I'm a lobbying firm that has a lot of lobbyists, I just go to Karen and all the other lobbyists that I work with and say, everybody give as a syndicate to Max Baucus to make sure that the corporate communists don't have to compete while everybody else in this country does have to compete. For example, again, preventing competition so that our healthcare companies can continue to take money without actually having any real competition.
Well, it's interesting. This research, I think, puts a fine point on the connections, how the lobbyist contributions really echo and complement those of their clients. It isn't a smoking gun, however. I should say that there is no proof of coordination just by the fact that there are all of these contributions coming from and really representing the same sources. We don't know if it was raised through a fundraiser or if it was raised by the client or by the lobbyist. We don't know the direction and the motivation necessarily. But we can say that these lobbyists who are marching up to Capitol Hill to lobby on behalf of their clients have a big dollar sign on their back. They represent so much money from themselves, their colleagues, their family members, and their clients.
Well, politically speaking, though, Dylan, too, I mean, you have to ask yourself, you look at the composition of the committees, you look at the dollar donations that they're getting. This is how business is done in Washington. This is how political compromise gets made in Washington. Maybe we'll get a little bit of change, but not so much change. And that's sort of what we're seeing, I think, with Wyden.
Jake, the more I learn and see this, the more I suspect we don't have a two-party system, but we have a one-party system where it's those who have the money to control Democrats and Republicans to ensure they don't have to compete. They get tax loopholes, et cetera, and then everybody else that gets screwed. Is that basically how this country's set up right now?
Increasingly, that's the way it starts to look, doesn't it? I mean, I think the problem here, too, is that we're just simply not able to track who is having the real influence on this bill. At least we haven't been. And so there's a real onus now on Congress to release more information about who is having that influence on them. And so that when it comes time for us as a citizenry who sent them to Washington to really represent us around these truly vital and important issues to this country, that we're able to track who is, in fact, influencing them. That's what it's really about, money and influence. And we're now, for the first time, starting to see who is actually having that with numbers and dollar signs through this new work.
And Senator Baucus actually told us who was influencing him when he refused to bring competition and choice to health care. Take a listen to his comments at 1 o'clock in the morning last Thursday.
I cannot think of a major member either so opposed by both business and labor, both. There must be some wisdom there if they're both opposed, and I just think that you've done a lot, Senator, but I don't think this amendment really is the right thing to do.
And the wisdom, of course, is that, again, business and labor accumulates more power and more money by perpetuating a version of corporate communism as opposed to having to compete like everybody else in this country. And again, if you look, Sheila, and I've been using Open Secrets to do this, at the multiples, forget the dollars. If you just look at which senator and which congressman gets 2, 3, 4, 5 times more money than the average senator or congressperson, it tends to be very telling as to their voting record. Do you have the technology, Sheila, that you could calculate people's voting records with the multiple? In other words, those who get the most from health care, here's how they voted on these types of issues. Those that get the least, those that get the most from corn lobby, unions, banks, whoever it may be. Can you do that?
We do that on specific bills where we think there is an interesting pattern of contributions going to the yes vote versus the no vote. There is also an organization that utilizes our data to do that kind of a mashup, the vote correlation, called maplight.org. So this is an interesting way to look at the money and the votes to see whether or not it's a party line split or, in fact, if the money is telling about potential motivation behind the vote.
And how often is the money telling?
You know, it's interesting. It's not always the causal effect here. If it's a party line split, I think that is more interesting, more kind of the factor than the money. But on occasion, particularly where it's an intra-industry fight, where the consumer and the constituents aren't really at the table, but it's maybe the banks fighting against the credit card companies, or a very arcane issue, that's where the money really has the potential to speak and speak loudly.
Understood. And that's where corporate communism makes its money, so God bless them.